Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today I have prepared interesting problem for you. I don't know if you would be able to solve it or not, but at least you may try. So imagine that we have two families. Here's one family on the left, here's another family on the right, and we know that individual E and F are full siblings. Additional information would be that none of these children have been adopted, none of the parents cheated, and none of them used any fancy techniques like IVF, or these children are not test tube children. How it is possible? And of course, there is no mix-up in a hospital. So, do you have explanation for what you see here or not? You have a couple more seconds and I will show you how it is possible that in two different families, children can be full siblings. And imagine now a situation where we have another male and female. So here is a couple, and this couple would have two monozygotic twins. And all the monozygotic twins would be of the same sex. So these two females would be of the same sex. And here's another parents. And this couple also has two monozygotic twins. And in this couple, monozygotic twins would be females, twins, sisters. And in this family we have also monozygotic twins, who is going to be males, would be brothers. And now imagine that one brother would marry one of the sisters, and another brother would marry another sister. And the children of these two couples would be considered to be full siblings. So this child would be related to this family just like their own child. And this child E would be related to this family just like their own child. And these two children would relate to each other just like two full siblings. So if you see descending line that then splits to two lines, that means monozygotic twins. If you would see something like this, so two lines split right away, that means twins, but not monozygotic. Monozygotic twins have to be always of the same sex because they're going to be genetically identical, but dizygotic twins can be of the different sex. Say, can be male and female, because dizygotic twins would result as fertilization of two egg cells by two sperms. And in this scenario, when two twins would be monozygotic, we start with one egg cell that has been fertilized by one sperm, and then it divided in two, and then these two cells would separate and each would develop into the fetus. So both children would be genetically identical and of course would be of the same sex. So once again, every child here would share 50% of their genes with one of the parents, with the second parent, with aunt, and with uncle, the same 50%, just like with their parents. And this child here also would share 50% with one of the parent, 50% with another parent, would share 50% with the aunt that is going to be genetically identical to mother, and also would share 50% with genetic makeup with uncle, who is going to be genetically identical to father. So all these lines represent 50% of relatedness. And also would be 50% related to each other, just like full siblings in one family. So I hope this information has been interesting to you, you learned something new today, and this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.